There's a really powerful movie called Saving Private Ryan. The basis of the movie is that a mother had a bunch of boys in World War II, and all but one has been killed in this war. The War Department got wind of this, and they just couldn't fathom that she's going to lose all of her boys. So they sent a team of Rangers out to Europe to find Private Ryan, the remaining son, the only son left. Mama, take this badge from me. And they went through battle after battle trying to find Ryan. I can't use it anymore. They finally found him, said he's coming home, gave him the news about his brothers and stuff. It's getting dark, too dark to see. And the act of this group of men saving one man's life. Well, I'm knocking on heaven's door. Every single one perished, except for Ryan. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Ryan's the only survivor of that. Everyone else died for him to live. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And a really powerful moment came at the end. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. It's the future Ryan. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. In his 80s probably. He's at Normandy, he's looking at all the grave sites, and he's overlooking, I believe, his captain. And he's crying, he's getting teared up. Behind Ryan is 40 people that never would have lived if Ryan didn't live. Mama put my guns in the ground. I mean, Ryan got married, had kids, and they had kids, and they had kids. I can't shoot them anymore. He's a grandfather, great-grandfather, life, and you know, that one person created all of this stuff. Oh, the cloud is coming around. But if it wasn't for these guys. And I feel I'm knocking on heaven's door. Who gave their life before their time. Knock, knocking on heaven's door. To preserve the one person's life. Feels like I knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And all those people behind him in the screen never would have existed. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And Ryan, the elderly Ryan, is looking at the grave. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And his wife's next to him. And he's getting kind of emotional. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. As I am a little bit. And she tries to embrace him and comfort him. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And he turns to her. Feels like a knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. And says, knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Was my wife worth the sacrifice of all these men? Mama, tell me. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. If that doesn't make you get the fuck up and do something, I don't know what else. Because all those men that died for Ryan to live, don't tell me that their spirits, their afterlife, they never had family or kids maybe. Don't tell me they don't feel the connection of being married through Ryan's marriage. Having a kid, Ryan did. Don't think they feel the fatherhood there. Having a family. I don't think that they can feel, they never felt it live in mortality. Don't tell me that the opportunity they gave to him, they don't feel an immortality. What that means. It's a responsibility there. To live life to your fullest, because so many, even better than us, have perished well before their times for us to have this beautiful thing. We cannot take that in vain.